is time for our Star Trek and Orville news. We don't have Orville news this week. Eventually, when it comes back, we'll have more. But the big news of the week, we're finally getting Star Trek the Motion Picture in 4K, and we now have a date for its debut on Paramount Plus, April 5th, First Contact Day. This is a remastered 4K scan of the original negative, giving us the director's edition in a way we've never seen before. Enhanced visual effects, Dolby Atmos sound mix, and we're going to get to see it on the screen as well. Fathom Events will screen this new edition on May 22nd and May 25th. Tickets go on sale April 8th. And yes, there's a trailer, and yes, it's gorgeous, and yes, we got a link to it in the notes, so you can take a look. Amanda Rowe posted over on Twitter this photograph of the clapboard marking start of production for Strange New Worlds Season 2. Season 1 will hit Paramount Plus on May 5th. Jerry O'Connell says that he's seen two episodes. He says, it's everything and then some. He's Mr. Number One, of course. And Leslie in the chat, hope they're not enhanced Lucas style. No, we've seen some clips. It's just basically sharpening and adjusting color and making things a lot cleaner than what we had before. So it's just prettier. There's nothing new. It's just enhanced what was already there. So hopefully that makes everybody feel better. Okay, Trek Movie reports confirmation that Star Trek Prodigy will be coming to Nickelodeon in international markets beginning April 8th. Network will air the first 10 episodes from season 1. Worldwide rollout begins in the UK, France, Spain, Portugal, and then later Singapore, Malaysia, the Philippines, Nigeria, South Africa. So all of those of you who are Star Trek fans in those countries, you have that to look forward to. And over on Twitter, Star Trek Timelines teasing a new event featuring three versions of Dax. Esteemed Curzon Dax, Yidran Dax, and Blood Oath Jadzia Dax. This is an event called Symbiosis. It's going on now. The different Dax characters are brought together through a temporal anomaly crisis, which gives access to symbionts from the future, and now you have to rescue a Trill with centuries of advanced knowledge. There's also a new ship being introduced, the Karima ship, I think level 4. This event going on now. It ends Monday at noon Eastern. So if you're playing Star Trek Timelines, there you go. Now, this next story is a little thin. The official Star Trek account posted to Twitter what looks like cover art for a new book coming from Titan. It's called The Art of Neville Page, written by Joe Nazzaro, featuring the artwork from Page, who's been the lead creature designer on both Picard and Discovery. He's been with the franchise ever since the Kelvin reboot as a creature designer, and this book collects his designs. They say it's coming in September, but I have not been able to find anything else on this anywhere. There's no note on Titan's website. Doing a search just generally to see if anybody is reporting on this, we haven't found anything else. So it looks like it's coming, but we don't know. Star Trek Wines has a new campaign in place. Mrs. Walker, you may be interested in this one. It gives people a chance to choose their next product. Now, they've already got a Chateau Picard. They have a Klingon blood wine and a Cardassian Kenar. Now they're about to add a wine based on the wine of Ryza. This is the vacation planet. There are two versions. Now there's the bottle we saw in Enterprise, and there's a more modernized bottle we saw in Guinan's Bar in Picard. Star Trek Wines would like you to choose. They've launched a fan poll in order to help decide which bottle you want them to package this in. So we'll have a link. We have a link in the notes so you can have a say. It's entirely possible if there's a tie, maybe you get both. Maybe. And Tim mentioned Numbskull earlier. Here's another one from them in their Tubbs line of collectible cosplaying rubber duckies. These are officially licensed, ladies and gentlemen. Q in his judge outfit from the pilot and the finale, and a Borg. These join the other designs in the Tubbs line. They're running about $17 each. This is the kind of thing that Ernie would sing to, right? Rubber Ducky, You're the One. I had to, right? I'm not going to sing it, though. And that's all we've got for your Triple Bytes. Don't forget to like and share, and we will have more next week.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.